the wheels seemed to reconnect with the road surface. And of course, because the front wheels were turned extremely in this direction, so suddenly the man was spinning like this around the road. And so we were chanting, "Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Hare Hare." And the man flew off the road. Last thing I remember is sound of smashing glass. Then everything became dark. Then, some moments later, I found myself, I appear to be floating in darkness, in some void. I could understand that I exist as spirit soul. But whether in that body or not that I was just in, I could not tell. I thought, I was actually thinking, well, maybe I'm now in the next room. I actually thought like that, because I was just in complete darkness. There was no sense impression, nothing. So then I thought, what should I do? Well, if I'm in the next room, if I'm dead, if I'm now preparing for rebirth, I should chant the right Krishna. So then, with that desire, I was trying to chant, find some way to chant, and then my consciousness reconnected with my tongue, my mouth, and I understood, oh, that is still here. So then I began to chant, and while chanting, my consciousness spread to the rest of the body, and I could understand, oh, everything is here, both arms, both legs, it is there. And then some feeling came. So I felt there was some pain near in the ribs, some pain on my arm, but not very serious pain. So I must be, then I tried to move, and I could move. It was not so bad. So then I sat up, and I found myself in the middle of a potato field. And I looked back, and there was the man upside down, completely smashed, completely wrecked. And everything inside looked spilled over the potato field. I realized, actually it was our good fortune. They always tell you, fasten your seatbelts. But if we had fastened our seatbelts that night, we would have been dead. Because the top of the van had crushed the two-foot seats. So we had, for some reason, Krishna had caused us to neglect fastening our seatbelts. And we were only thrown to the front windshield. So then I looked around, it was dark, it was full moon night, that was very significant, but the moon was covered by clouds, so it was quite dark. Full moon night in Transylvania. And then I looked around and I heard some sound. It was Bhakti Vaibhava Swami. He was injured. He was thrown on the other side. He was injured. So he was making some sound, but simply sounds of pain. Not even speak properly. And on this road, once in a while, some car or some truck was going by, so I thought, now I have to stop some truck and get involved in calling for help. So I thought, but I should have my passport, I should have some identification and money and these things, but everything is thrown all over the field. And if I just go up on the road and stop, who knows? These people may arrest me, or other people will come and plunder this van, and everything will be lost. Not good. But at the same time, I have to get help from Maharaj immediately. So then what to do? So I stood up, and I began to walk. It was dark. I could not see where I was going. I was just walking. And I was chanting, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Ram, Hare Ram, Ram. And then suddenly from, I'm not trying to be dramatic, this is just what happened. But from inside, from in the heart, I received the inspiration, now you stop. Stop right here. So I stopped. Now reach down. I could not see anything. I could not see what was down. But the inspiration was, you reach down now, and find what is on the ground in front of you. So I reached down and I touched could feel some glass, and then a picture frame. So I picked it up and brought it close, and in the dim moonlight I could see this fierce visage ripping apart that Hiranyakashipu, lifting his intestines out. So suddenly I felt very secure. I felt that now there will be no worry. Although look at our position. Man is smashed, Bhakti Vaibhava Swami is seriously injured. Everything is scattered. I'm telling this story. This happened in Transylvania. Everything is scattered across the potato field. So then I just began to pray to Lord Shingadev. I put the picture to my heart and I said, Lord Shingadev, please help me. I have to assist Bhakti Vaibhava Swami getting to hospital. But for this, I need my papers, I need the Lakshmi, and I don't know where anything is. So then, from within the heart, I was told to walk. So I was walking again in the darkness, and again, stop! So, now reach down. I reached down, I picked up my Gita. I began to chant, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna. And then again, walk. So I was walking, and then now stop. I reached down into the darkness. I picked up my wallet for the Lakshmi passport. So then I went to the road and some car, this Romanian car, Dacia, was coming. And they stopped and inside were two ex-soldiers who happened to have full training in dealing with injuries. So I said, my friend, he's hurt. They, in Romanian, Dumnezeu, Dumnezeu, which means, oh God, great God. And they came out, and they very careful, because he was, Maharaj was crouched like this. He actually had two broken ribs, we found out later. So he was crouched, he was in pain. So without straightening out the body, they very expertly lifted up and put him in the back seat. Then, because Dacia is a small car, there was no room for me, so drove off. I stopped one truck and followed to the hospital. So, in this way, I have my own personal experience that Lord Shingadev, it's not simply that he is there off, you see, beyond the shells of the universe, and it is very difficult to call him, it's like some unnamed philosophers called deists. Their philosophy is that God made the world, he put us in it, and now he's gone away. Now he doesn't care anymore, so you have to fend for yourself. No, actually, Lord Shingadev is most enthusiastic. This is the special feature of that form, that he is there to protect his devotees. So, everyone should be convinced this fact, that at every moment, traversing this razor's edge of spiritual life, we need Lord Narasimhadev's protection. Just like now I have been somehow elected as chairman of the GBC. So in this position, I become very aware of all the dangers. I was not so aware before. Some, but now it's always coming. Every time I go on calm, the computer, there's another emergency. And again, I'm thinking, who am I? How can I deal with this? Actually, some days after that election, when they elected GBC officers, and then like a great weight, this was placed on me. Now you are chairman. Then I was seeing one night, there was a full moon in Mayapur. There was a ring around the moon. Very strange. A ring of light around the moon. This did not seem auspicious. I didn't know what it meant, but it seemed to be auspicious. Then some inquiry was made. And it was reported back that some Vedic astrologer was consulted what this means. He said, it means some important leader will die this year. Or have I just been elected chairman of the GDC? I was thinking now I... And this is what I see in the sky. Then, some nights after that, there was comet. Some comet for a few nights, I don't know if you noticed, passed overhead in Bengal. Then there was eclipse, lunar eclipse, which is also not very auspicious. And then I understand next year in 77, there will be a huge comet that will come. So these are all very, very dire portents, very inauspicious. So we're here in the material world. It is a place of danger at every step. We have declared war on the material nature. Our path is the edge of a razor. Can you imagine that? I once saw at the Thai Busan Festival in Malaysia, a man was walking up to the bottom gate on the blades of swords, the sharp blades of swords they were putting in front of his feet. Skin was not broken, but the sword was going right up to the flesh. So that is our position, actually, according to Upanishads. We are stepping, and by day into Krishna consciousness, we are walking on the edge of a razor sharp sword. So much danger is there. So, what else can we do? Except throw ourselves under the lotus feet of Lord Narasimhadeva. We must become dependent. You see, the dependent child, he is the child who actually attracts the loving mercy, the loving protection of his parents. One must become fully dependent, yet at the same time, just like Prahlad Maharaj, he was fully dependent. But that did not mean that he did not do anything. It's not dependence in that sense. That everything is up to the Lord. I won't do anything. I am too weak. I can't do it. No. And also, it does not mean to become fully dependent on the Lord. It does not mean to be reckless, to take unnecessary risks. Just see. The example of Sri Prahlad Maharaj. Now he is certainly fully dependent. After all, he's only 5 years old. And his father is Hiranyakashipu. Prabhupada wrote in the third book. The very personification of materialism. A demon so powerful he could conquer the free world. And his little son was devoted. So, it is not that Prahlad Maharaj then just took shelter of the Lord and was so meek. He was afraid to do anything. Just protect me, protect me, protect me. Help. No, actually, he was preaching. He was preaching to his own demoniac schoolmates in school, and telling them to raise your hands, chant the holy name of the Lord. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare. Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. But he was not reckless. He did this during Tiffinam. That's very noteworthy. The teachers, they left to take their lunch, and then he took that opportunity. So to place oneself under this shelter of the Lord means to take risk to serve the Lord, yet at the same time use one's intelligence, not place oneself in unnecessary danger. So in this way, this Krishna consciousness movement under Srila Prabhupada's direction has gone on and is going on. But ultimately, everything we are doing, our efforts to preach, our arrangements to protect this movement, one must use intelligence in so many ways. They all depend upon Lord Narasimhadeva. So let us, on this day, the day of his most wonderful auspicious appearance, in which he tore apart the demon Hiranyakashipu and saved his devotee Sri Prahlad Maharaj, let us all, with full heart, full enthusiasm, call out for the Lord's protection. Sri Narasimhadeva ki jai!